The neutrino-less double beta decay is a commonly proposed and experimentally pursued theoretical radioactive decay process that would prove a Majorana nature of the neutrino particle. To this day, it has not been found. Double beta decay is a phenomenon in which two neutrons in an atomic nucleus are converted into two electrons and two protons. Two antineutrinos are also emitted at this time. This two-neutrino double beta decay process is allowed within the standard model of particle physics, although the decay rate is extremely small. On the other hand, there is also the other process of double beta decay in which the emitted antineutrinos are converted to neutrinos inside the atomic nucleus and are absorbed, and as a result no neutrinos are emitted. This neutrino-less double beta decay is not permitted by standard model of particle theory, and requires the new physics beyond it. Neutrino-less double beta decay occurs when the neutrinos are Majorana particles. In other words, if this decay can be observed, this would prove that the neutrinos are Majorana particles, and that itself is a remarkable discovery. This would provide support for the neutrino seesaw mechanism, which naturally explain why neutrinos have such little mass compared to other fundamental particles. Neutrino-less double beta decay does not conserve the lepton number before and after the decay. This lepton number violating process is an important step toward explaining the mystery of why our universe is composed only of matter with all the antimatter having disappeared. Finally, if the half-life of neutrino-less double beta decay can be measured, it will be possible to derive an absolute value for neutrino mass from the formula which describes the relationship between half-life and neutrino mass. The Super-Kamiokande experiment and other neutrino oscillation experiments have shown that neutrinos do have mass, and hence that there are mass differences between the different types of neutrinos. However, the absolute mass of a neutrino has not yet been measured. If the absolute value of neutrino mass can be measured, then it will be possible to identify the neutrino mass hierarchy.